that's easy to say. We have a list of people that we would take. A bullet for them, a bullet for you, a bullet for everybody in this room, but they don't seem to see many bullets.
Made it to Las Cruz. I'm at the library or outside of the library, about to go in. But
yeah, I stopped at one store, just got a few things that I needed. Other than that, I mean, I don't really have any plans for today. It was just to get forward somewhere. And I did that. Like I said, I think I may go to the rest stop that's probably like an hour and a half away from here and stay there for the night. I'm glad I'm leaving when I am, because I don't know if everybody got off work, or I guess maybe it's lunchtime and they got to do stuff, but it's getting packed out here. I am next to the city hall too, so it could be that, you know, they got to pay bills and stuff. But I did want to show you this too. I had some leftover food, and so I wrapped it in aluminum foil and left it in the window. So this is one way to reheat your food if you have a microwave. It's a little warm. It's not that sunny out today, so it's not going to work as good. But I think I'm just going to go ahead and head towards this rest stop that I'm going to stay at. I don't even know how far away it is. But I think I'm going to just go ahead and head there and just chill out there for the rest of the day. I don't have anything else planned. Like I said, I mean, everything that I looked up to do around here, you're going to be spending some money at some point. And I'd rather not do that. I'd rather get into Arizona and find a job. That's the plan right now. I've enjoyed my journey out this way. I did get to charge up everything though in the library. That's why I like to go in there. It's not only that, but it also has AC. So instead of sitting in the van or sitting outside being hot, I can be in the AC. I can also watch movies, stream movies, watch YouTube, whatever. So that's why I go to the library a lot. Not just to edit videos and upload videos. Although that too. But I got to charge up everything. What I'm going to do now is charge up this power pack. I've told you about this in my other video, but I didn't show you exactly what I'm doing. On the back of this, you see the little plug right there. That's where you charge. So I have my inverter right here. And I'll just plug this into the back of there. And then the other end goes into the cigarette lighter spot. Like I said before, it did say that you could use a 12 volt adapter thing, which you would just put into the 12 volt spot here and then into the cigarette lighter thing up there. But this is what I have right now, and it works. So it says only do like 30 minutes so you don't overdo the battery. So I'll normally like, I don't really time it, but I'll do it for a while, unplug it, let it sit for a while, do it again. Then I'll check it, because whenever you unplug it, it shows on here how much power it has. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do while I head out, is plug this up, plug my LED light up, because I haven't had to charge it ever since I hit the road. So, I mean, I've used it every night for a week, basically, and it just died last night. So I'll charge that up again on my drive, and that's about all I have to charge right now. Everything else is charged up, so we're good to go. Let's hit the road. Yeah. Yes. Thanks. Made it to one of these cool little rest stops that have these sheltered areas out here. I'm not sure if I'm going to stay at this one tonight or go a little bit further to the next one. I think it's only like 20 more miles to the next one. But here's our food up here. Sun came out, so it's definitely, yeah, it's definitely hot. It may actually be dinner. I don't know yet, because I don't really feel like cooking at this point. So yeah, I'll leave that sitting up there until it's time for me to eat. Like, they have lights under there, nice clean area with trash cans, and you're right next to the rest stop area, so I'm sure they have
Some toilets in there, restrooms inside, I'm sure. It's a nice little spot to stop at. Got a little view over there.
Birds fascinate me. Like, they just glide with no care, no effort, really. You know, they flap their wings when they need to, but they know they're gonna fly.
Here's another little tip. Use a bungee cord to keep your door secure when the wind's blowing really hard. And I know I haven't showed you like the inside of my van in a while, like especially during the day, but I have no more room in my cooler for my spinach, so I'll have to eat that by tomorrow. And I have my AC bungeed in. I know you can't really see it too good, but it's on the doorknob on the inside. It wraps around it and it connects onto the dresser that I have in here. And that's how it stays secure. I took the wheels off the bottom of it as well. So it just sits right there. And this is what it's looking like inside. Got extra water back there. I did have my 5-gallon bucket back there, but I can't fit in between there very well. So I went ahead and moved it up front and got a lid for it. I'll show you that in a second. My hammock's on the floor. But yeah. That AC thing is usually on top of there, and I have to take down my pots and pans because they make too much noise when I'm driving. And I put up the Ultra Touch just to cover up that area, and I have my chairs that I have sitting outside normally up there, and just some random stuff. But yeah, let me step back so you can see. It's my bed, but it's a nice little area in here. It gives me a little walk-in space. And I have enough space up here to get ready in the morning and whatnot. And normally I'll take down my window covers for these side doors, and I'll put one on the bottom of the cooler and one on the top just to keep it a little bit cooler. And then here's my 5-gallon bucket. I bought one of those lids for it and put that on top so then I can sit that up here and, you know, no smells are getting out or anything, and it doesn't look too bad. And then I have more water over behind there. It's a little dark. There we go. It's more water in my little weed spray bottle that I use to wash up with. And my butane stove is right there. Just some snacks and whatnot right there. Got some snacks in my cargo net. My water bungeed in up there. This is my kitchen area you haven't really gotten to see too good because it's been dark every time I record. And there's a bunch of my kitchen stuff. And then inside of here, it's the rest of my kitchen stuff. All my bowls and plates and cups and canned food. And then I have a container. I know you're not gonna see that too good. But I have a plastic container with all my rice and flour and all that stuff in there. And then a bunch of baggies. But yeah, and then my hygiene stuff is up there. And then I have some more in that storage area. And then over here is a bunch of like computer stuff and wires. I narrowed that down a whole lot. So yeah, that's what it's looking like in here. And that's up front, which is a mess. My laundry is in that tote that's in the middle that my power pack's sitting on top of. And then I just have my towel and gym bag and all up front. So yep, well, that's my van when you can actually see it during the daylight. And yeah, I'm gonna hang out here. I may even like take a nap or something. I'm not sure yet. And I'm gonna see how far that next one is, because there is a rest stop that has Wi-Fi, which I don't need it because I have full bars, 4G service right now. So like I said, I may just stay here for the night because I'm a little tired. Tired of driving at this point, although I only drove like a little over an hour and a half. But yeah, I only have probably like another hour and a half, 2 hours until I hit Arizona, and then I'm in the stretch at that point. Then it's just finding a job. So cool, that's what's going on. Thank you all for sticking around with me through this journey. I'm only gonna do like one more day of this as far as recording a daily vlog to post that up for you all. Then after that, it'll just be like a collage of my experiences in Arizona for this winter. So Thank you to my new subscribers. Thank you to everyone who's donated so far. That just gives me a morale boost. It's pretty crazy. Even if you donated a dollar, for you to even attempt or to make action into donating, that means a lot to me. So I really appreciate that. And another way to donate to me is to just like my videos, thumbs up my videos. That's a good way to donate to me, as well as share them, or as well as comment. If you comment below, if you share it to other people who are interested in this type of a lifestyle or whatever I'm talking about, that's awesome, and that helps me out. It helps boost my channel. So that's a way to donate to me if you don't want to donate financially. But yeah, thank you all for sticking around, and I'll see you all tomorrow. I went about another 37 to 40 miles to this welcome center right before you go into Arizona. And as I was pulling in, I heard this noise, and I could tell my oil pressure had dropped. So I'm pretty sure that leak I had is oil. Although when I checked the fluid the past few days, nothing changed on it until this last drive. So definitely going to have to get that checked out. I thought I had oil because I have like one of everything at least. But apparently I don't. I'll pull over to the gas station and get some oil in the morning when I get some gas. Which is just right. You know, not even a mile away from here. So yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. Not too happy about it, but you know, at least I made it this far. I'm gonna call it a night here. Looks like a nice place. I'll tell you about it tomorrow when I get up to head back out, and we're gonna see how the van does at that point. But yeah, so this will end it for today. We're half a tank and empty heart, pretending we're in love with the